is that with doing so much as far as information and trying to share in this last generation, the volume of experience that I've had, you know, and especially in Evotionals, getting a chance to personally talk to directly to you, to say, this is what I have seen, this is what I have done. You know, I wasn't a perfect saint, you know, I wasn't somebody who went out in the ministry, you know, and never sinned, but rather I had faults, you know, I had failures, I had successes, but in every situation and every circumstance along the way, God was there, and that God was real, and that He never forsook me, never left me alone, but that always, whenever I turned to Him, whenever I looked away from my circumstances that either I had created for myself and failed, or I had created in some way and succeeded, I could turn to God, and I could see, and I could hear, and I could know His forgiveness and His mercy and His kindness all the days of my life, in everything that I've done. And I like to say that I'm the chiefest of sinners because I've tried everything. If you could have frustrated grace, I would have done it. And yet in reality, that was also God forming and fashioning the person that you see before you today. Am I anybody special? No, not really. I'm just like you. I've worked, I've lived, I've loved, I've lied, I've told the truth, I've been a sinner and I've been a saint. I've nearly died 3 times, I've been revived. I've been on the mountaintop of transfiguration, I've gone to the first heaven as it were and been amazed at what I saw there. Long to someday go back. I've been in the valley of despair. I've had spiritual experiences that to this day boggle people's minds. But in all of these things, it was nothing unique or different. It's the same as you or I mean the same as you or anyone around you could experience for themselves. Because you see, God wants you to know Him. And God will use whatever purposes and plans He can to bring you into a personal knowledge of Him, of knowing God, the living God, Himself. He loves you so much, He gave you His Son. And in Jesus we find all of the Father revealed to us. In God calling, forget and forgive. O Lord, we thank Thee for so much. We bless Thee and praise Thy glorious name. Fill your world with love and fill it with laughter. Never mind what anguish lies behind you and what you failed or didn't do. Forget, forgive, love, and laugh. Treat all as you would treat me, with love and with consideration, and let nothing that others do to you alter your treatment of them. The challenge will always be to find in yourself the compassion and the mercy that God has given you to extend it outward to others. Because whenever you're provoked, the first situation and circumstance should always be to turn that provocation into an invocation of asking God to lead the way. Because without God's help, when you're provoked, you will react rather than act according to His word. When God gives us anything that provokes us or allows it to come into our life as a provocation, then we have the decision to make of how we react to it. Will we stop and realize and recognize what the situation and circumstances are? Or will we let our emotions rule and guide us? When we turn to God and ask Him to lead and provide for us His wisdom, then we can appreciate the understanding that is needed in order to address the situation where God may want us to be Jesus to someone else who has a need that may have just provoked us. And we need not be the provoker or be returning provocation for provocation, but we might be able to turn the direction of someone else back to God where it should be. Wouldn't you like to be Jesus to someone else? You know, it's really easier than you think. God is in you. You just got to let Jesus lead the way.